Team Rwby. We know them, we love them. They're a perfect team, a perfect family. But was their coming together really just happenstance, or was it guided by a higher power? We already know from Raven that Oz gives special perks and privileges to the teams he believes he can use in order to groom them for his holy war. But what if he also arranges those teams? Let's take a closer look. Rwby Rose is a silver-eyed warrior blessed by the God of Light and is arguably the ultimate weapon against the Grimm. Weiss Schnee is a freaking trillionaire. Forget her glyphs or her ridiculously OP summoning. Weiss is set to become the richest and most powerful person on the planet when she inherits the company, assuming Jock ever gives it up, and will thus have nearly complete control over the entire dust industry. Blake Belladonna is a former member of the White Fang and daughter of the former leader. She is almost guaranteed to be a leader to her people down the road and offers her team access to worlds completely separate from their own. Plus, she helps Weiss with her racism. Yang Xiaolong is Ruby's big sister and will put protecting her above all else, perhaps even her own humanity. She's also related to three of Ozpin's last generation soldiers, so there's that too, and she has incredible raw power. These four are quite literally the best team I could imagine, and once fully grown will likely be incredibly influential. By earning their trust, Oz wins the next generation, and will ensure his next incarnation has an incredibly easy time rising to a position of power. Now I know what you're thinking. Just King, what about Pyrrha? And I can't deny that she is probably the strongest in terms of combat of her year. But there's just no place for her on the team, and more importantly, she's needed elsewhere. That same power of hers that put her on cereal boxes has also cut her off from everyone around her. She needed someone who wouldn't treat her special. She needed someone to fight for, and he needed to learn how to fight. Now, I'm not sure how Oz knew about John's semblance, but I suspect his grandfather might have fought beside Oz in the war and shown promise, because there's no way John forged his way into the school without Oz knowing. Oz knew there was potential, and that he needed a private tutor to bring out his true power, but he also knew that John's pride would keep him from accepting help. This may actually have been part of the reason why John was made a team leader, so that he'd accept her help to grow stronger and more confident for the sake of his team. So that's my basic theory on why those teams were chosen ahead of time, but that still leaves a question of how they were forced together. I mean, we all saw them launched off a cliff and then randomly search the woods until they crossed paths. It certainly doesn't seem like there was any way this could have been set up. But I think there are two distinct possibilities on how Oz may have done this. The first is his weird wizard powers that are still pretty undefined and could have been used to manipulate the paths they took. The second is if he used a relic. As we know, the relic of choice is hidden somewhere in Beacon, in a very elaborate way such that Salem hasn't found it. Now, we don't know exactly what this thing will do, but given its name, I could certainly see it being able to manipulate students into going exactly where he wanted. This may be less likely given the Relic of Knowledge has such a long reload time, but the Relic of Choice may have different limitations that we aren't yet aware of. Regardless, this would explain why he constantly looked distracted when Glinda kept trying to talk to him, because he was focused on getting the students paired up properly. I doubt he would have told her what he was doing, given his whole spiel on free will and freedom being so important. We get it, he's a hypocrite. Though this does still leave the question of why would he do this? If he wanted a certain team to end up together, why couldn't he just assign partners? Well, I think Weiss answers that quite nicely when she spends an entire episode having a hissy fit about Rwby being made team leader. I'm sure if they knew the teams were preordained, people would have tried to get them changed or just pouted and complained instead of learning to work together. So, my final 2 points. Crow and Raven. Ren and Nora. Rwby and Yang. These are the only people we know of who knew each other before coming to Beacon, and they all just happened to end up on the same team as each other. This definitely feels like something Oz did intentionally to keep the teams focused on themselves instead of worrying about others. And finally, please, just for a minute, imagine Blake Belladonna being paired up with Carden Winchester. Yeah. I don't think Oz would have ever let that happen, because it would most certainly end in the death of a student. So please, let me know what you think in the comments section down below. Do you think the teams were manipulated, or am I just overthinking things? I have a few other Rwby videos in the works, so be sure to like and subscribe if you don't want to miss them. And until then...
peace.